Or should we run off and join a pirate ship? No, no.
It's no use, Joe.
Please,
Joe,
don't.
We've got to have it
no.
out. I have
hey.
Loved you ever since I've known you, Joe. I couldn't help it. And I tried to show and you wouldn't let me, which is fine.
No.
But I must make you here now and give me an answer because I cannot go on like this
Penny,
any longer.
Please, please
I gave
don't.
Up billiards. I gave up everything you didn't like. I'm happy I did. It's fine. And I waited and I never complained because I figured you'd love me, Joe. And I realize I'm not half good enough and I'm
oh,
not this great
yes,
man.
Yes,
and
yes, you are. You're a great deal too good for me. And I'm so grateful to you and I'm so proud of you. And I don't see why I can't love you as you want me to. I don't know why.
Who cares about danger when there's love?
Ugh, Anna, ugh. Kissing won't save the forest.
You know, you just might turn out to be a great writer.
Oh, Norman, I hope so. You know, every time I touch a book, or read a story, or even when I just open the dictionary, something inside of me goes thump. And my heart starts pounding, and my stomach. Well, you know, it's how people are supposed to feel when they fall in love. Of course, I never have.
I'll go with Weiss. Son, you can go with Blake. And Neptune, you can go with Yang since she doesn't have a partner. Everyone good?
Actually, RWBY, why don't you go with Yang? After all, she is your sister.
But Weiss, who would go with you then?
Well, I guess Neptune could come with me.
Nah.
But!
Look, I've never felt any pressure from you that I co-parent. But your idea that I take no responsibility for raising your child is naive. It's not that I think you're not capable of raising a child on your own. Of course you are. But short of us dissolving our partnership, I'm not capable of not being involved. Not as a child's father, but as its mother's friend. I mean, I'd lay down my life for you. So if you succeed in adopting a child, I'll lay down my life for him or her. It's as simple as that.
Sorry, Matthew. I just don't want you to miss out on love.
I don't know how you could think that I don't have love. I have you.
Sunny had become a habit. And Ayas didn't know what to make of that. It wasn't romance, she knew that much. Romance had never been her thing. She watched him as he traced the path back from the bed to where his pants had ended up. He picked up the rumpled pair and dug around in a pocket. "Do you mind if I," he asked, holding a retrieved red reed pipe and an accompanying tin, Ayas shook her head. Not at all. He'd never done this before, and she found it endearing. This wasn't part of a seductive script. There was nothing in this for her. The man wanted a smoke. On the clock, though he was, something had shifted enough for him to feel comfortable not spending every second entertaining her. They were just hanging out now. She liked that.